Hello and welcome to the pCon Planner video tutorial on single image rendering. In pCon Planner, you can create a compelling rendering from your design in just 3 clicks. With a few additional steps, you can customize your visualizations and refine the result to perfection. To render an image from your open design, first, make sure the view you want to render is active. The active view is indicated by a green border around the corresponding viewport. Now, about those promised 3 clicks. First, click on the Presentation tab. With the second click on Image, you open the rendering dialog. The third click on Play starts the rendering process. pCon Planner immediately shows you a preview and provides an estimate of the rendering time. Once the rendering is complete, you can copy the final image to your clipboard using the copy icon or save it as a JPEG, PNG, or bitmap to your hard drive. Simple as that, and just as effective. Let's now take a look at the general settings you can adjust for your renderings. Under Type, you can choose between a standard image or a 360-degree panorama, which allows a full view of your scene. Under Size, you define the resolution of your image in pixels. Several preset sizes are available. And if you want to specify a custom size, select User-Defined at the bottom of the list. Under Renderer, you can choose between the two rendering methods available in pCon Planner, OSPRay, a CPU-based renderer for creating photorealistic images, and OpenGL, which renders an image of the current planning view. Here's a helpful tip. The Image Area option allows you to see the exact portion of your workspace that will be rendered. This feature takes the aspect ratio of the output image into account, ensuring that all essential details are included in the rendering before you hit play. Now that we've covered the basics, let's dive into the advanced settings that can help you create your perfect image. By clicking on the pencil icon, you open the advanced settings for the selected renderer. You can also use the gear icon to select predefined profiles. Let's start with OpenGL. Its advanced settings are relatively straightforward. In the Basic Settings tab, you can adjust the quality of anti-aliasing, which affects the smoothness of fine lines. In the Background tab, you can decide if the background of your image should be transparent, or if not, whether it should use the current view's background. With OpenGL, you can render an exact one-to-one image of your current planning view. This means the rendering uses the active display mode and includes symbols for cameras, light sources, dimensions, and 2D elements. If needed, these symbols can be hidden using the layer filter in the Start tab. This functionality allows you to export any standard display mode, from wireframe to realistic, including custom render styles, as an image in any size. It's an excellent option for quickly sharing a planning view. When it comes to photorealistic renderings, the second renderer, OSPRay, comes into play. With its powerful features, it produces high-quality visualizations that showcase your projects perfectly. By clicking on the gear icon, you can choose from predefined profiles. In this video, we use OSPRay Standard as a base. The advanced settings for OSPRay are divided into 4 sections: Processing, Output, Tone Mapping, and Special. In the Processing section, you first set the stopping condition, which determines the image quality at which the rendering process stops. The simple level completes the rendering the fastest, making it suitable for checking camera setups or lighting conditions in your renderings. For high-quality results, the medium setting is usually sufficient, offering a good balance between quality and rendering time. If you want to depict highly detailed scenes and materials, the high level delivers excellent results but requires more computation time. The unlimited option lets the rendering process run indefinitely until you manually stop it. Using the custom option, you can define a variance threshold value between 0 and 10, where 0 represents unlimited. Lower values extend computation times, but also improve the achieved quality. The next section, light calculation, determines how many light sources in the scene are considered per rendering pass. With the truncated option, only 1 light source per pixel is processed per pass. This setting is particularly fast and, in simple lighting scenarios, barely distinguishable from higher levels. Simple is sufficient for most scenes, and we recommend medium as the standard setting. If your project includes complex lighting scenarios with multiple light sources and effects, you should choose High or Maximum. With Maximum, all light sources in the scene are considered in each rendering pass, achieving the most precise result, though the computation takes longer. The choice depends on the complexity of the lighting situation and the number of light sources. If you only use ambient lighting in your project, with no additional light sources, the lighting calculation setting has no impact on the result, and you can safely select the truncated option. The third setting, ray depth, defines how many times a light ray reflects in your scene before its path is terminated. A practical example to illustrate this is considering transparent objects like glass panes in your scene. Each pane requires two reflections, one when the ray enters the glass and another when it exits. If your scene has three consecutive panes, a ray needs at least six reflections to pass through all of them correctly. If the ray depth is lower than the required number of reflections, the areas behind the glass will appear black, and the reflections on the glass might overlay this blackness. Higher ray depth allows light to follow more complex paths in the scene, which is especially beneficial for dark, enclosed spaces, or scenes with many reflective surfaces. A value between 6 and 10 is sufficient for most renderings. The contribution threshold setting helps reduce aliasing effects in brightly lit areas of the rendering. The default value of 10 works well for most use cases. The optimal setting depends on the desired outcome and the specific lighting conditions of your scene. Let's move on to the next section, output. Here you have three options available, including denoising, which is enabled by default. Rendering produces what is called image noise, small, irregular dots or grains, particularly visible in dark or dimly lit areas of an image. Denoising acts as an intelligent filter that removes this noise using AI, smoothing the image without losing important details or fine textures. The result is a clear and clean rendering, which is especially beneficial for detailed scenes. You can toggle denoising on or off at any time, during or after the rendering process. The next option allows you to export your image with a transparent background. This is particularly useful if you want to add your own background later in an image editing program. Make sure to save the image in a format that supports transparency, such as PNG. The Create HDR Image option lets you save renderings with a particularly high dynamic range in HDR format. The OSPRay renderer always generates HDR images during rendering. By enabling this option, the full brightness and color information are preserved when saving the rendering, as no tone mapping is applied. This option is ideal if you plan to further edit the images in tools that support HDR. When enabled, you can save the image in EXR format. After saving the full dynamic range with the Generate HDR Image option, the Tone Mapping section in pCon Planner allows you to adjust color range, contrast, and brightness using different methods. This ensures your image looks as natural as possible on screens. The default method, Filmic, is an industry standard. Like Drago and Reinhard, it compresses the contrast range in brighter areas more than in darker ones, creating more dynamic and authentic images. You can adjust tone mapping at any time, even after rendering, to save your scene's optimal representation. Finally, let's discuss the last section. The Architectural Camera option helps avoid converging vertical lines in renderings. These occur when vertical elements like walls or windows appear tilted and taper upward or downward in perspective views. This often happens when the camera is angled up or down, which is especially noticeable in architectural visualizations. The Architectural Camera option straightens these lines, ensuring they run parallel to the image edges, resulting in a more harmonious and realistic representation. This feature is particularly useful for creating architectural images where vertical alignment is important, such as facade views or interior spaces where a correct viewing angle is critical. The Shadow Plane option is useful when visualizing individual products or typicals without a floor in the scene. This feature adds a virtual floor at height zero, where shadows of objects are cast, preventing your objects from floating in a white void and adding more depth. Ensure that objects are planned at height zero, as the shadow plane is fixed at this height. If there is a floor in the scene, this option should be disabled. With the Keep Lines option, lines and 2D elements, such as contours or floor plans, remain visible in photorealistic renderings. This setting is especially useful if you want to retain technical details or drawing lines in your renderings, enabling a combination of realistic representation and technical information. Once you've configured all your settings, you can save them as a custom profile. Simply click the little plus icon between the gear and pencil, assign a name, and create profiles tailored to different rendering scenarios. This way, you can quickly access your preferred presets anytime. If you want to add a logo to your image after rendering, you can do so directly in the image dialog. Open the path to the logo file, and use the position tool to set where the logo will appear in the image. If you want to render multiple images simultaneously, the pCon Planner Pro version offers batch rendering. Simply select the camera perspectives you'd like to render. The selected perspectives are then processed sequentially. You can close pCon Planner or continue working on another project while the batch rendering runs in the background, automatically saving the finished images to your hard drive. Now you've learned all the essential rendering settings for single images in pCon Planner and how they work together. With this knowledge, you'll be able to create impressive renderings to visualize your projects effectively. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to subscribe to our channel to stay updated with more informative pCon Planner tutorials. Have you seen this video? Here you'll learn how to enhance your renderings using a lighting environment. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.